Hello everyone, welcome to Power BI 0 to Hero playlist. My name is Sandeep Raturi. In this video, I will explain you types of licenses in Power BI. Here is the list of licenses in Power BI: Power BI Free, Power BI Pro, Power BI Premium per user PPU, Power BI Premium Capacity, Power BI Embedded, and Fabric Capacity. Let's understand Power BI Free license. Here you can see the Power BI Free license information. With Power BI Free license, you can create reports and dashboard. You can only publish reports to my workspace, and you cannot share your work with others. Means you can only use Power BI Free license for your personal use. Dataset limit for Power BI Free license is up to 1 GB per dataset, and storage limit is 10 GB per user. User can store up to 10 GB of content, including datasets, reports, and dashboards in their workspaces in the cloud. This limit is cumulative across all workspaces they own or contribute to. With Power BI Free license, you can refresh your reports 8 times per day. And when you will create an account with your work mail ID, you will get a free license. Power BI does not support personal email IDs such as gmail.com, hotmail.com, and yahoo.com. Power BI only support work mail ID. Let me show you the website where you can sign up. So you can see here, this is the Microsoft official website. I will provide this URL in video description. You can access from there. And here you can see the start free. Once you open it, it will navigate to you app.powerbi.com. Here you can enter your work email ID and click on submit button. And after that, follow the instruction and you will get the free license. Now I will explain you Power BI Pro license. Why Pro license is required? If you want to create and share reports and dashboards within your team or within your organization, then a Pro license is required. Here you can see the few capabilities of Pro license. You can share reports and dashboards with other Pro users. You can collaborate within shared workspace. You can publish apps to the organization. It supports paginated report, and you can export the data to PowerPoint, Excel, and PDF. And it supports data governance and lifecycle management. Dataset limit for Power BI Pro license is up to 1 GB per dataset, and storage limit is 10 GB per user. And with Pro license, you can refresh your report 8 times per day. And the cost for Pro license is $10 per user per month. Now I will discuss with you Power BI Premium per capacity license. Target users for this license is large organization or teams needing scalable and high performance capacity for sharing reports and dashboards with an unlimited number of consumers. And capabilities are: content can be shared with any users, even those without Pro or PPU license. It supports paginated reports, AI features, and large data sets, deployment pipelines, multi-geo support, and XMLA endpoint. Dedicated capacity for enhanced performance, collaboration in shared workspaces, and enhance scalability for complex dataset models and high consumption. Dataset limit for this license is up to 400 GB per dataset. And storage limit is 100 TB tenant level storage. After this, I will discuss with you what is tenant level storage. And you can refresh your reports 48 times per day with premium capacity license. And cost start for this license around $4,995 per capacity per month. Now understand what is tenant level storage. A tenant represents the entire organization that subscribes to Microsoft services under a single domain, example google.com. The storage applies to all content created and managed within Power BI or Microsoft Fabric, including datasets, the size of data models, report files, data flows, paginated reports, and any other artifacts stored in Power BI service, workspaces, or fabric environments. Example, suppose your organization has premium capacity with 100 TB of storage, and your organization may have several departments or teams, each with their own workspaces in Power BI, sharing this total 100 TB. Means team A could use 10 TB of the storage, team B might use 20 TB, and the rest is available for other teams or workspaces until the total used storage hits 100 TB. Summary of this: tenant level storage means the entire storage quota is shared across all users, teams and workspaces in your organization, Power BI or Fabric environment, rather than being individually allocated to a specific user or department. Now, I will explain you Power BI Premium per user license. Target users for PPU license are advanced users and small teams needing premium features without needing full capacity-based licensing. Means, if you have a small team and you want to access premium features without purchasing premium capacity license, then you can go with PPU license. Capabilities of PPU license are access to advanced features like paginated reports, AI, XML endpoint for external tools, and deployment pipelines. User can collaborate and share content with others who have PPU or premium capacity. Larger dataset support and more frequent refreshes. Dataset limit for PPU license is up to 100 GB per dataset and storage limit is 100 TB tenant level storage. You can refresh your reports 48 times per day and cost is for PPU license is $20 per user per month. Now I will discuss with you Power BI embedded license. Target user for embedded license is independent software vendors or developers looking to embed Power BI content into applications. Capabilities are embeds reports and dashboard in custom apps or website. Means if you want to integrate Power BI reports or dashboards with custom applications such as .NET, Java or Python, so you can go with Power BI embedded license. For this requires technical development resource to integrate, and pricing for embedded license is based on capacity usage, and dataset limit is up to 400 GB per dataset depending on capacity tier, and storage limit is 100 TB tenant level storage. I already explained you tenant level storage, and you can refresh your reports 40 times per day with Power BI embedded license. Now I will show you the price list for Power BI embedded license. I will provide you this URL in the video description so you can access from there. And here you can see the embedded license pricing. The total cost of Power BI embedded depends on the node type chosen and numbers of nodes deployed. Node types differ based on number of vCores and RAM as outlined in the table below. So you can refer this table for pricing. Now I will explain you Microsoft Fabric capacity license. Microsoft Fabric is an integrated platform that combines Power BI with other services for data engineering, data science and real-time analytics. Target users for Fabric capacity license are large organizations needing end-to-end data analytics solution. And capabilities are combines capabilities across Power BI, Synapsys, Data Lake, Data Engineering, Real-Time Analytics and Data Science. Let me show you the feature of Fabric capacity license which you can use. So you can see here I am in Power BI service, and in left hand side bottom you can see the Power BI. Once you click on Power BI, it will show you the features of Microsoft Fabric. So here you can see Data Factory, Data Activator, Industry Solution, Real-Time Intelligence, Data Engineering, Data Science and Data Warehouse. So with Microsoft Fabric capacity license, you can use all these features. So from here, you can create lakehouse, you can use notebook and many more. You can create the data warehouse, data flow. So these all are the features of Microsoft Fabric capacity license. And these features you cannot use with premium license. So this is the main difference between both. Now back to the slide. Capacity types is scaled similar to Power BI Premium, offering dedicated compute power. The larger the capacity, the more data can be processed concurrently. Dataset limit for Fabric capacity license up to 400 GB per dataset, same as Power BI Premium. And storage limit is 100 TB tenant level. With Fabric capacity license, you can refresh your report 40 times per day. And cost for Fabric capacity license is similar to Power BI Premium capacity, around 4,995 per capacity per month, but scale depending on data processing and workloads. This is the summary table of Power BI license comparison. With Power BI free license, dataset limit is 1 GB and storage limit is 10 GB per user. And you can refresh the report 8 times per day and cost is free. For Pro license, dataset limit is 1 GB, storage limit is 10 GB per user, and 8 times you can refresh the report. and cost is $10 per user per month. For PPU license, dataset limit is 100 GB, storage limit is 100 TB tenant level, and 48 times you can refresh the report per day, and cost is $20 per user per month. For premium per capacity license, dataset limit is 400 GB, storage limit is 100 TB tenant level, and 48 times you can refresh the report, and cost is $4,995 per month. For embedded license, dataset limit is 400 GB, storage limit is 100 TB tenant level, and 40 times you can refresh the report, and cost is based on capacity. For Microsoft Fabric capacity, dataset limit is 400 GB, storage limit is 100 TB tenant level, and 40 times you can refresh the report, and cost is $4,995 per month and up. That's all for this video. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more great content. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.